Hello friends, I am Dr. Ashish Agrawat. Welcome to my channel Live Biochemistry. Today we will discuss about the metabolism of xenobiotics. Okay, it can be also called as a biotransformation or detoxification. Okay. So we will discuss all this terminology: what is xenobiotics, what is biotransformation, what is detoxification. And there are two phases of this metabolism, okay, first and second. And in this video, we will discuss about the phase one of metabolism of xenobiotics. And in next video, I will discuss about the phase two. So what is this xenobiotics? Xenos means stranger, foreign compound. It may be food, drug, chemical, carcinogen, additives, preservative, and pollutants, which can be produced in the body, in the intestine by the bacterial enzymes like indole from the tryptophan, phenol from the phenylalanine, or during the normal metabolism. Here, these xenobiotics are the all compounds which has no nutritive value, and it is potentially it is toxic. So all the food, drugs, chemical, carcinogen, additives, preservative, indole, phenol, all these compound can be called as the xenobiotics. And we will see the metabolism of this xenobiotics. Now, what is biotransformation? Transformation is from one chemical, another chemical is formed. And bio means inside the living organism, living cell. So in our body, one chemical compound that is converted to another chemical compound, that is called as a biotransformation. It can be detoxification, means toxic substance are excreted, that is called detoxification, or it can cause intoxication. Okay, so where a toxic compound becomes more toxic, that is called intoxication. Okay, so here the foreign compounds are subjected to metabolism through a series of the reaction and converted to less toxic, less harmful, and more excretable. That is called as a detoxification. So here this compound, like lipophilic compound, non-polar compound, they are become more polar and water soluble so that they can be excreted in urine. Okay. So in biotransformation, liver is a major organ. In other organ also, like intestine, the metabolism takes place, biotransformation, but liver is the main site. And organelle where this biotransformation is taking place, that is the microsomes of endoplasmic reticulum. So here there are two phases of biotransformation. Phase one, where there is oxidation, reduction, and hydrolysis reaction taking place. In the phase 2, there is a conjugation occur, some combination of all of this. Okay, now what is the hydroxylation, which is a chief reaction? So in microsomes, in the liver, there is an enzyme called as a monooxygenase or cytochrome P450, which is also sometimes called as a mixed oxidase. Okay. And what it will do, it will add hydroxyl group to the steroid, to the PUFA, to the xenobiotics, to the drug. Okay, so any xenobiotic compound with the help of NADPH, it is converted to hydroxylated product so that it can be excreted. So in microsomal, there are two types of cytochrome P450, right? One is microsomal, that is used in the xenobiotics, and one is mitochondrial cytochrome P450, that is for the steroidal hydroxylation. Okay, for the formation of steroid synthesis, this is required. And inducible enzyme synthesis increase in administrative of the drug. Okay, xenobiotic compound is hydroxylated, oxygen is converted to H2O, and cytochrome P450 is converted to oxidized form. Oxidized form converted back to NADPH, with the help of NADPH, cytochrome reductase, it is again oxidized, and with the help of NADPH, it is converted to NADP. This is how cytochrome P450 works. This P450 means here the cytochromes is the iron containing, okay, compound, and they take up the wavelength 450 nanometers, right? That's why they are used. So there are many isoforms. There are many isoforms of cytochrome P system, okay, and this genetically different form of this cytochrome P450 is responsible for different drug response. Okay, so suppose I am taking the drug aspirin, and my body in the liver, in my cytochrome P450, it metabolizes fast. Okay, so, and it will give a action. So it will, like, it is anti-inflammatory, painkiller, aspirin, so it will work. In other person, it may be slow metabolism in the liver, slow metabolism of aspirin, and it may lead to the toxic effect also. Okay, so that is why there is a different drug response, that is something called as a pharmacogenomics, right? So that is related to this cytochrome P450. This system is mainly in the liver. Now, other reaction that is taking place is oxidation, okay, in phase 1. So, alcohol, they are oxidized to the acid form. So, methanol is converted to formic acid, ethanol is converted to acetic acid, and benzyl alcohol is converted to benzoic acid, which can be further conjugated with the, suppose like glycine to form the hippuric acid. Right? Then aldehyde, that is benzaldehyde, is converted to benzoic acid. So first alcohol, that is converted to acid, like methanol converted to formic acid, ethanol converted to acetic acid, and benzyl alcohol converted to benzoic acid. In aldehyde, benzaldehyde is converted to corresponding acid, that is the benzoic acid. So one is alcohol oxidation. So you have to remember this example, you have to mug up at the end. It is frequently asked question in your theory exam also, so you have to, at the last moment, you have to revise it again. So in oxidation, so what we have to write so far, okay, so far in biotransformation, that is the, what is biotransformation, that is conversion of one chemical to the another chemical. Okay, it can be detoxification, it can be entoxification, detoxification. Okay, so detoxification is from toxic substance, it is converted to less toxic substance, or it can be converted to more water soluble compound from non-polar substance, right? And xenobiotic is any food drug additive which has no nutritional value and which can be potentially toxic. So our body will metabolize that substance. It can be pesticide or anything, right? And liver is the main site where there is a hydroxylation cytochrome P450 enzyme is there, right? And it will in microsomes of the liver, they are metabolizing with the help of cytochrome P450, and NADPH is required. Now, phase 1 reaction is the 3 reactions are there: oxidation, reduction, and hydrolysis. In oxidation, there is the oxidation of alcohol, okay, oxidation of aldehyde, oxidation of amines, oxidation of sulfur drugs, okay, oxidation of aromatic amines. So we will see in one by one. So alcohol, we have already seen, it is converted to acid. Aldehyde is converted to corresponding acid. Amine, they will be converted to oxidative deamination and converted to corresponding acid and nitrogen, like aliphatic amine converted to aliphatic acid and urea. Aniline is converted to para-aminophenol. This is important, you have to remember, right? Then aromatic hydrocarbons like benzene is converted to phenol, and acetanilide converted to aminophenol. Organic sulfur is converted to sulfuric acid. Okay, so I am again revising. There is a phase 1 reaction. Phase 1 reaction. So the first phase reaction is oxidation. Right. In oxidation, you have to remember oxidation of, suppose, alcohol. So formic methanol alcohol is converted to formic acid, ethanol is converted to acetic acid, and benzyl alcohol converted to benzoic acid, right? So this alcohol is done. Then you have to remember about the aldehyde. So benzaldehyde is converted to benzoic acid. Clear? So alcohol AAA, okay? Alcohol aldehyde, then amines like aniline is converted to aminophenol, okay, an aliphatic amine is converted to aliphatic acid plus nitrogen like urea, okay. So alcohol aldehyde amine, that is clear. Then aromatic hydrocarbon like benzene, okay, or acetanilide, which is converted to aminophenol. Benzene is converted to phenol, and sulfur group is converted to H2SO4, right? So this is about the oxidation. Now coming to the reduction. So very important is picric acid is converted to picramic acid, so they are converted to amine, okay, amino group. So nitrobenzene is converted to aminobenzene, picric acid is picramic acid, and disulfiram, it is reduced to dithiocarbamic acid. At least these two you should remember. And chloral is converted to trichloroethanol, right? So in the reduction, you have to remember it is converted to amine, so picric acid is converted to picramic acid, right? And nitrobenzene is converted to aminobenzene. Okay, these two at least you have to remember. Okay, if you can remember, the disulfiram is converted to dithiocarbamic acid, that's very good. Okay, and chloral converted to trichloroethanol. But at least you should remember these two examples. Then third is hydrolysis. Aspirin is acetyl salicylic acid. So it is converted to acetic acid and salicylic acid. And atropine is converted to tropic acid and tropine. And digitalis, okay, it is converted to sugar and A glycone. So ester amides and glycosides are hydrolyzed by esterase, amidase, and glycosidase. Okay, so this ester aspirin is broken down by the esterase enzyme. This amidase atropine is converted to tropic acid, and this glycosides is converted to sugar plus A glycone. So again, I revise about the hydrolysis. So esters like aspirin, it is broken down to salicylic acid, and acetic acid. Atropine is converted to tropic acid and tropine, and glycosides, they are converted to sugar and A glycan by the glycosidase enzyme. Now coming to the MCQ portion. So all of the following are the phase 1 biotransformation reaction except, okay, so this is a MCQ. So acetylation, hydrolysis, oxidation or reduction. So as we know, oxidation, this is going on, reduction is going on, hydrolysis is going on. So which is not this, the correct answer will be acetylation. Okay, so except, so acetylation is not a part of phase 1 reaction, it is a part of phase 2 reaction. Then 450 in cytochrome P450 denotes 45 option are 45% of cytochrome CYP1000, 450th member in the family, molecular weight is 450 kilodalton, or absorption peak at 450. So your correct answer is the cytochrome is a heme containing enzyme, it has absorption peak at 450 nanometer. Okay, so these are very important MCQ. So this is about the phase 1 reaction in metabolism of xenobiotics. Okay. So one you have to remember that there is a hydroxylation occur at in the liver by the microsome cytochrome P450 system. Then you have to, because cytochrome P450, because absorption peak at 450 nanometer. Then three reaction, that is oxidation. So what are the example you have to remember about the alcohol? Ethanol is converted to acetic acid. Okay, then aldehyde, benzaldehyde is converted to benzoic acid, corresponding acid. Then amines, like aniline, is converted to amino phenol. Then aromatic hydrocarbon, okay, like benzene is converted to phenol, and sulfur group is converted to H2SO4. These are the example of oxidation reaction. Then reduction, most important is picric acid. This all example you have to remember. So picric acid is converted to picramic acid, right? And nitrobenzene compound is converted to amino benzene. You can remember the disulfur sulfuram also example. Okay, and lastly there is a hydrolysis by the esterase or glycosidase enzyme. So drug like atropine, right? Digitalis, which is broken down to sugar and aglycone, and aspirin is broken down to salicylate and acetic acid. This is all about the phase 1 reaction. Regarding the phase 2 reaction of biotransformation, I will discuss in my next video. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share my video, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell icon so that you can get notification for my future video also. Thanks for watching. Bye.